But first, what's the old saying? How many people does it take to change a light bulb? Well, the same can be asked of Labor. How many Labor MPs does it take to understand how the economy works? I was shocked to watch the Prime Minister on Sky News this morning completely fumble over his words when asked serious questions about the pressure government spending is putting on inflation. Now, it's something Labor and the states, for that matter, have been warned about for some time. They are spending too much. They need to stop doing what they're doing. Not that Anthony Albanese seems to understand that.
Are Australians facing higher rates for longer because of big spending federal and state budgets?
Well, that's not what they've said, Peter, with respect. And the truth is...
Well, this is the quote here from the RBA. Public demand is forecast to be stronger than previously expected, reflecting recent public spending announcements by federal and state governments. Are you saying they're wrong?
Yeah, that's very different. That's very different from the way that you characterised it, Peter. We've made sure fiscal policy, budget policy works arm in arm with monetary policy.
Well, that's not working at all because the RBA and Treasury are brawling at the moment.
That's not true, Peter.
Well, you're saying completely different things.
We agree that inflation... No, we're not. No, we're not.
Well, that's not what the Reserve Bank thinks. In its statement on monetary policy, it says public demand is forecast to be stronger than previously expected, reflecting recent public spending announcements by federal and state governments. Yet clearly the Prime Minister has a problem with the RBA's warning, and the Treasurer has a problem with the RBA's warning too.
Budget spending is not the primary determinant of prices in the economy, but we can be helpful, and we are being helpful, with the design of our cost of living policies, which help us get back to targets sooner.
As I said, how many Labor MPs does it take to understand basic economics? The RBA Governor Michelle Bullock said it would take 2 years, 2 years, to bring inflation down to where it should be. And the opposition is quite rightly sounding the alarm.
Anthony Albanese had a train wreck interview this morning on Sky News with Peter Stefanovic. It's clear to me that he doesn't understand the basic economic principles. The Reserve Bank Governor has warned of the Labor Party splashing more money at a federal and state level into the economy in a way that will drive up inflation and therefore interest rates.
And there's really only two possibilities here. One is that the Prime Minister doesn't understand what he's talking about, and that is a possibility because this is a bloke that's often not across the detail, or he was trying to willfully mislead you and your viewers. The RBA has been crystal clear here on multiple occasions now.
See, the issue is Labor don't seem to understand much when it comes to the economy. Have a look at this tone-deaf social media post put out by Anthony Albanese on X. It says, new album just dropped, with a photo, as you can see, imitating the So Fresh Australian compilation CD series. The cover reads, so helpful, cost of living relief, winter 2024. And in place of top songs, the album cover references government initiatives such as cheaper medicine, tax cuts for every Australian, $300 off power bills and $3 billion of student debt wiped. I mean, seriously, give me a break. So helpful, he says. More like, so out of touch. He still has not seemed to quite grasp that cost of living is no laughing matter. It's no joke. The rental crisis is no joke. Bills through the roof, no joke. The cost of petrol or groceries, no joke, and I could go on and on. Who is actually in charge of this country? Apparently it's DJ Albo. Oh, and also, of course, inflation. And if the PM's social media post wasn't bad enough, it's been hit with community notes by X, which means the post contained untruths. He has been called out for publicly lying. It says many of the policies cited do not fully come into effect until much later than winter 2024. E.g., paid prac for students doesn't start until July 2025. Paid parental leave will be phased in by 2026 and only $75 of the $300 power bill relief will be paid by winter 2024. So this is clearly not the album review DJ Albo was hoping for. He has been done for misinformation by X. His latest album has been a flop. though you won't see homegrown inflation on his album cover. As Simon Benson writes in The Australian today, the best analogy I've heard to describe the politics now driving the inflation debate is of the man who is told by his doctor to lose weight. Instead of cutting back on the carbs, the patient simply changes the scales. So maybe DJ Albo's next album drop could be called Inflation Station, because that is a big hit for Labor.